He collapsed when he heard his friend's words. His bright future vanished in a moment. Why had his family lied to him all his life? Protect his father. However, those lies were about to collapse, and he wondered what he had done. Steve Lichtig thought his life was just beginning. He'd graduate and join the Marines in a few weeks. He wanted to maximize his remaining time with friends and family. His friends kept a secret and waited until the last minute to tell him. The town knew the dark secret. All but Steve knew. Steve, one of nine children, never noticed his big sister Joni's age gap. Mary and Don Lichtig told him they wanted another son, so he never asked. He believed that only his lifelong friends could tell him the truth. He didn't know they'd go so far to protect their schemers. Steve's parents tried to keep him from discovering the truth. Steve sensed something was wrong. He always felt something was wrong. When he reached adolescence, he assumed the unease was due to being a teenager. Despite his best efforts, the feeling persisted. Something wasn't right. The tight-knit community knew what Steve didn't. His teachers, neighbors, friends, and high school girlfriend knew about his real father. Rumors followed him. The Lichtig scandal remained hidden for 18 years. His family and friends tried to hide the truth, but all secrets eventually come out. Was Steve ready? Steve was happy the day before his high school graduation, unaware of his family's dark secret. He was with his best friends Vance and Alan, unaware that they had decided to end the lies. If you like my videos, don't forget to like or subscribe. Thanks in advance. Despite their parents' secrecy, the boys knew it was time. They told Steve the ugly truth because no one else would. They thought he should discover his father's past. Vance glanced at Alan and approached the topic carefully. He carefully considered how his bombshell would affect Steve. He knew Steve's parents would be mortified if the family name was ruined. Steve would join the Marines soon. Last chance. Steve, he whispered. Steve initially misunderstood his friend. Vance's message eluded him. Vance told Alan, no. He needs to know. What was he looking for? Your sister, Joni, well, Vance continued. Steve felt the world shattering into millions of pieces as his friend told him everything. They filled my silence with what they knew. They told me who my mother was and that they had known for basically their entire lives, Steve said later. And that everybody I had grown up with had known for their entire lives, and they felt that this was the time I needed to know. What happened? Steve's mother. Moreover, who was his father? Vance confessed that Steve's biological mother was Joni, his older sister. Steve was astonished as his friend spoke. Who did he think were his parents if his sister was his mother? After the revelation, nothing fit. Steve had no idea who he was. After Vance finished, he asked him his only question. Anyone? Steve asked wide-eyed. Alan gently replied, everyone. Steve was incredulous that the town had lied to him. Betrayed, he became enraged. His real father abandoned him. His identity and everything he knew vanished in a puff of smoke, revealing the ugly truth. He did his best. Steve waited 6 weeks before telling his parents. Steve smiled at his graduation. It was a sham. This was the middle of May 1987, Steve recalls. I spoke at my high school graduation the next night, went to all the parties, and did everything. The time bomb would explode soon. Steve said, I held it in for another month and a half, and then I confronted my parents, my grandparents, about it. I fled as an angry 18-year-old. I drove 20 miles to the nearest town and rented a motel room with my friends. Someone knocked on the door. Steve opened the door to Joni, his lifelong older sister. She confessed. Yes, this happened, we thought. Sorry. I was mostly silent, he said. Would Steve's grandparents and biological mother explain why they lied now that the secret was out? Part of it was the time of this, which was the early 70s, Steve said. The community members who knew but didn't say anything were trying to be good neighbors. To protect the family name, Joni's parents adopted Steve after she became pregnant out of wedlock. But this isn't unusual. Dani Shapiro, who interviewed Steve on her podcast, Family Secrets, says that home DNA kits are helping more people discover their true lineage. She called it epidemic. But should a family keep such personal secrets? Dani told Today that people have a right to know and feel liberated by the truth. The secret keepers have a burden, but the question is when they should share it. Can Steve face his personal truth? Steve joined the Marines after discovering his sister was his biological mother. He married and settled after his sentence. He became a successful NBC News journalist, but his marriage ended in divorce. Joni, Don, and Mary Jane never discussed his true lineage again. 15 years later. Open Secret, Steve's 2013 documentary, chronicled his experiences. He interviews grandparents, childhood friends, and siblings in the film. He wanted to illuminate a murky subject throughout his life. He needed to self-discover to find the missing details. Steve told KRWG how that revelation changed him. You know, not until 15 years later, he said. It wasn't discussed. I know it sounds dramatic, but I changed that day. Steve's family relationship was strained after the family secret was revealed. In high school, he was a happy-go-lucky guy, but something shut off in him and the relationship ended. It was mandatory for the whole family. My family is big, 6 sisters and 2 brothers. I separated myself because I thought they were in on it. Would the Lichtigs reconcile? Steve imagined his mother's suffering. She lied after giving up her child. I was trying to understand what she must have gone through to have had a baby, and then see your own parents take the baby, and then tell you that the story is going to be that you have to tell this baby that you're his sister, not his actual mother, and you have to live that for basically the rest of your life. Would Joni have given him up? She says she didn't want to give me up. My parents insist she needed the help. Like most things, it's in the middle, Steve said. And I do believe that she was told this is the story, if we're going down this road, this is the story we'll use and you'll stick to it. The family was informed then. How would they rate the film? Joni wasn't ready to discuss the details with Steve's biological grandparents, Don and Mary Jane. She married and had more kids. Steve was disillusioned. She disdained his self-discovery and documentary. I saw your film, she said. I understand, Steve said. I don't want anything more to do with it going forward, so please don't ask me. We've emailed a few times, but we haven't talked in a long time and it's not the outcome I expected. But Steve felt relieved after filming. I need these conversations, he said. The film allowed us to have a conversation that would not have happened otherwise. So yeah, I can walk away and say this did what it was supposed to do. Steve is happily married and wants children. After making peace with what happened, he had another burning question. Ask Joni how involved she wants to be. Steve wondered if his kids would call her grandmother or aunt. Joni exclaimed, smiling. Joni. The documentary spread Steve's story worldwide. Media outlets wrote dozens of articles, interviews, and shared it on Facebook. Commenters started sharing similar stories. Steve's situation is actually quite common. This happened to my uncle, actually my cousin, everyone knew except him. My other cousin, his brother, told him when he was 17 or 18 because he thought he already knew, one woman wrote. It was a mistake to keep that from him for so long because he was very mad at everyone. Some Facebook users shared their stories and gave parents advice. I was adopted as an infant but not told until 23. Tell them young? There's no reason to lie and hide a person's true history, one user said. It's a terrible selfish act that causes bigger problems. Honesty is always best. When I found out I was adopted at 20, I went through so much anger and hurt and it took years to forgive because I felt so deceived, another woman wrote. Although I'm in my 30s and feel blessed to have such a great family, I don't think it's a good idea to wait to tell your kids they're adopted. However, I don't know the right age. Thanks. Happens all the time, especially back in the day, another woman said. Today, society accepts single-parent households headed by a woman who chose life. I won't judge this woman or Steve. You never know what someone is experiencing or has experienced. Individuality. Different strokes. A recent Gallup poll shows that society is much more accepting of women having children out of wedlock than it was in the 1950s, 1960s, and 1970s, and Americans become more accepting every year. In 2012, 54% of people said having a child while unmarried is moral. 60% in 2022. Why? Gallup found that morality is becoming more liberal. The morality of having children out of wedlock has changed the most in the last 15 years. Same-sex marriage tolerance is another major change. Out-of-wedlock births are more accepted, but that doesn't mean they are best for the child. However, a growing body of research suggests that children raised in two-parent households are more likely to succeed academically and emotionally. What about children like Steve, who were lied to their whole lives? This story shows how much the vaunted, traditional values that some politicians and others call for us to return to were based on appearance and outright hypocrisy, not actual morality, one Facebook user said. I just cannot fathom the mindset that thinks it's better to lie to a kid for 18 years than to admit his mother had him out of wedlock. However, some users defended Steve's mother. Teen pregnancy and unwed motherhood were different in 1969. Many things were kept secret. This family thought it was best for him. One user claimed he wouldn't have understood if told as a child. Her parents tried to protect Joni. They wanted to spare their family the 1969 shame. As far as real mom, let it go people. Think. Thanks for watching. I'll see you again in the next video.